Sometimes the comedy writes itself. This is hilarious and depressing at the same time. So I encountered an awful comment recently. That's nothing new. I get those all the time, right? And I will sometimes just ignore them, but sometimes I will respond at least once, unless they post a pointless insult or something completely off topic, in which case they're gone just as quick as they came. Often, I don't hear back from them after refuting whatever brain-dead take the dog world has in store for me that day. There's a lot of this, which I just refer to as drive-by bullshit. But this time, it was different. It all started when I posted a video titled Dogs Don't Belong on Buses, and soon forgot all about it and moved on to the next project. So then I see the following comment.
Yeah, I just flew on a plane with several dogs. Didn't hear a peep out of any of them. Humans are far worse to deal with than any dog I've ever encountered. I'm sorry you've had such terrible experiences with dogs.
That comment, by the way, came from a pit hag who's literally named Karen. You can't make this stuff up, and it gets much better than that. But we will get to that later. So I respond by explaining to Karen that dogs shouldn't be on airplanes in the first place, regardless of whether you can hear them or not, among other things. It's all there, and no reasonable person would find a way to misunderstand, right? Well, she dared to suggest to me that humans are somehow worse than dogs, and I even gave them the example of getting in an elevator, which proves that when you're forced to be in close contact with one or the other, it is almost always a dog that will do something inappropriate. Something gross or aggressive. Something needlessly antagonistic, rude, and assholish. Because as we know full well, that is how dogs are. And I figured, there's no way anyone can deny this basic fact about dogs. Honestly, I didn't even expect to hear back from her again after that. And believe me, if I never encounter her again, it won't be too soon. But no, she doubled down on her dog lunacy and hit me with this.
You are paranoid. Most dogs are not problematic the way you insist they are. Take it up with the idiot owners who have no control over their animals, rather than blame an entire species. But you won't, and that's your right to remain neurotically upset that dogs exist. I feel sorry for you spending so much time ruminating over this. You don't want to ride a bus with a dog? Get a car!
I kept my responses short and sweet, but there are really only three ways to respond to something like this. One. Completely ignore it. Obviously, anyone who talks like this is likely governed by dog brainworms. And yes, she actually had the unmitigated gall to utter these words on video.
I'm far more afraid of human beings. Well, if that's what they are. I don't know. Maybe they're human beings with a parasite mentally. I don't know, but...
Wait a minute. First of all, you're not going to speed past that like you didn't just say what you just said.
Maybe they're human beings with a parasite mentally. I don't know, but...
Talk about irony and lack of self-awareness. Honestly, I don't know what's funnier. The fact that she unironically talks about anyone having brainworms, the fact that she's literally named Karen, or the fact that the rage monster she owns, a literal shitbull by the way, is barking and growling and generally sounding like a demon for a significant percentage of her video.
Like some kind of little test to say, yeah, you can get on the plane. Georgie, like... Stop! But anyway, it's like, I feel triggered when I read some of these comments, because I'm like, why? I don't know. I don't know why this dog was so hell-bent on freaking biting me. It grabbed my hand, wouldn't let go, then it grabbed me by my jaw, and I'm...
Anyway, another way to respond is by just straight up telling them what an asshole they are. But they probably already know that, and don't care. They may even pride themselves on it. Conversely, they may be blissfully unaware as to the full extent of their unpleasantness and stupidity. So a third option is to simply explain to them how completely wrong and off base they are, and hope it sticks. Although you know that 98% of the time, at least, it won't. But maybe another reader will get something out of the exchange, and it is solely for their sake that I even bother with these triggered troglodytes, these contemptible cretins, these self-absorbed dog-worshipping assholes with vermin-infested residences. Now think back. This is the same individual who said to me, I'm sorry you've had such terrible experiences with dogs. But is she really? Of course not. Why would you say this, and not even two comments later, tell someone who's actually almost been killed by a dog that they are paranoid? Those three words, her saying, you are paranoid, tell you everything you need to know about her character. This is someone who can't handle the truth, and who thus resorts to gaslighting and insults. But what does she even mean by take it up with the idiot owners? Does she expect me to knock on every dog owner's house and tell them the truth? Believe me, if it were feasible, and if I thought it would accomplish anything, I would do it. But the owners aren't the reason dogs everywhere are total shit. That is how dogs are by default. It cannot be helped. She's just not getting it. Not to mention that there are dogs without owners as well. This is something these people never account for. Dogs are obnoxious with and without owners. Dogs are dangerous with and without owners. It has very little to do with the owners. The owners are wrong for having dogs, and you have to ask what it says about dogs that just possessing them is a problem. So they do share in the blame, for sure. However, at the end of the day, the dogs themselves are the direct cause of all the things they do. It's like if you want to stop an animal from eating your crops if you live out on a farm, you're not going to blame some owner who's assumed into existence. That would be psychotic. No. Realistically, you would take steps to stop that specific animal from eating your crops. Or if someone is stealing your mail. You're not going to go on a witch hunt for that person's parents, or some other party that's independent of them. You would want to find out who they are, and stop them from stealing your mail, or whatever it is they are doing. Dogs are just as capable of causing problems for people as anything else. In fact, they excel at it. If there's one thing dogs are good at, it is aggravating human life in countless ways. She also tried to say this. You're not going to believe the bullshit she said.
I can't imagine being wildly obsessed with hating dogs. So, I mean, these people act like dogs are like just running up in their houses and attacking them and shedding and shitting and pissing. This is the way that they're talking about it. It's like, don't you have control over your own home or whatever?
I already responded to this before as well. Here was my previous response. You do realize that you're just making something up and then pretending we said it. When in fact, we never said anything remotely like that. The only reason dogs aren't running into our homes is because we have doors. But actually, it's funny you should say that. I can't even open my door without one of these vermin aggressing on me. I once opened my door to retrieve a package off the ground, and some dog nutter's disgusting little crap beast was pulling at its lead to get to me, barking menacingly all the while. Dogs actually will attack us the moment we open our doors, and you want to defend something that behaves like that. And you do realize that windows aren't soundproof, right? You do know we can hear the mutant barking inside our houses and flats, right? I don't know what planet you live on, but where I live, dogs are inescapable. They really are vermin. Stick to whatever the hell it is you do, and don't open your mouth to talk about things you scarcely understand. But I want to emphasize how crazy it is that something she would make up and attribute to us, a proper straw man, would be so close to the truth. And actually, come to think of it, dogs do sometimes charge into people's homes to attack and generally intrude. Dogs are terrible. They cannot keep to themselves. They can't do it to save their lives. Seriously, what planet are these dog lunatics inhabiting? It can't be the same one we're on. And actually, I'd like to say one more thing about this take it up with the owner bullshit. One of the dogs that attacked me was literally a fucking stray. That means it had no owner. It nearly killed me. And I'm not going to blame someone who doesn't exist for what some stupid dog did. That would be as psychotic as slaving away to cook elaborate meals for one of these massive stench hounds which you've allowed to invade your residence. So listen carefully to this bit. The dog attacked of its own accord. It's what dogs do on instinct. They have prey drives and are intrusive and insufferable critters by nature. Limited though it might be, dogs have their own will, and stray dogs don't have natural owners floating around somewhere. Point being, strays cause the same problems owned dogs do, and vice versa. It is beyond a brain-dead take to insist that a person somewhere is somehow always responsible for what dogs do. No, they are not. And we aren't the biological parents of dogs. We shouldn't force ourselves to be their artificial caretakers either.
Somebody please help me!
Yeah, he was gonna attack my partner.
Is that my dog?
Put him inside.
This dog just came into my house and killed our cat. I can't get out.
They're much more dangerous than dogs. And I've been attacked by a dog once, so I'm a little leery at times. But I'm like, ugh. Because I was attacked by an ex-police dog. Why? I don't know. I don't know why this dog was so hell-bent on freaking biting me. It grabbed my hand, wouldn't let go, then it grabbed me by my jaw. And I guess I'm lucky to be alive. Anyway, I was about 13.
Let us be us, or watch the flood of a million other faces that are just like us. How can you see when you've got both eyes shut? Talking to me like I don't know what's up. Just like a tree, I'll leave them all piled up. What a feeling to be one of the sons you'll trust. Listen to me, the government's corrupt.
Here's another vocabulary word. Incorrigible. That's what this pit hag is.
Like some kind of little test to say, yeah, you can get on the plane. Georgie, like, stop. But anyway, it's like, I feel triggered when I read some of these comments, because I'm like, aren't you taking it a little far? Do you feel that way, those of you that, so, the dog owner? In that case. But anyway, do they really think that dogs are more dangerous than people? Because at this point, human beings with a parasite mentally, I don't know, but they're dangerous. They're much more dangerous than dogs. And I've been attacked by a dog once. So I am a little leery at times, but I'm like, oh, why? I don't know. I don't know why this dog was so hell-bent on freaking biting me. It grabbed my hand, wouldn't let go, then it grabbed me by my jaw. And I guess I'm lucky to be alive. Anyway, I was about 13. It was my friend's dog. I don't know what she took it out of the cage for. I was kind of scared because it was barking, and I've never been afraid of a dog before. But the way that I guess I could feel the energy, like, this dog wanted to fucking kill me. And I was just a 13-year-old. I was like 90 pounds. I'm like, what is this dog's problem? Why would she take that dog out of the cage? I don't know. Anyway, Lisa Kunkel, I'm talking to you, girl. Anyway, back in 83 or 4, no, 82 probably. Maybe it was 81. Might have been 1980. Yeah, 1980. Anyway, that was a long time ago, Karen. Yeah, the dog haters, I guess you need a space to vent. But it's just like, I just feel like they're taking it a little far. So, and people really hate cats, too. Like, despise them. I'm just like, I can see not wanting one. I don't want another one. After this cat dies, I will never get another pain in the ass cat again, because they run your world. She's in charge. She's semi-feral. Well, I mean, she was when I got her. But, I mean, she was friendly. She was a little teeny thing. She was real sick. She had an infected eye and all that. Anyway. But I'll never get another one. Oh, Cookie's like, I'm not a purebred, so there ain't nearly a damn thing wrong with me. I know. You're a good girl. I'm a good girl. I know. Get down. No, get down, honey. Damn dog. I could never take her. Well, she'd love to get on a plane, right? I can't trust you around other animals because you're just wicked. She's wicked. She's wicked. She thinks all small animals should die immediately. Right? Found her tied to a crack house. So we can't take her off the property because she's dangerous. And I won't because she's dangerous.
Keep the heads ringing.
Ring a ding, 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 dong.
Keep the heads ringing.